Hello everyone, welcome to FameWorld Educational Hub. Myself, Aishwarya Saxena, and this is a channel on which you are watching this particular video. I hope you have subscribed FameWorld Educational Hub, and if not, then please subscribe the channel and also press the notification bell for the latest uploads. We were dealing with the matplotlibs on the Jupyter notebook, and I hope you have watched the previous videos which have already uploaded on this series. So today I am going to start with histogram graph. So histogram graph is basically a similar version of a bar graph, but exactly it is not a bar graph. So let me just take a cell here. You can see that we are using the same Jupyter notebook. It is not required to create multiple notebooks when you are working on this Jupyter. So Jupyter notebook basically provides us the functionality that we can create multiple programs, multiple codes on the same notebook. So now I'm coming towards the histogram. So let me just tell you that what is the difference between the bar graph and the histogram. So when we are talking about histogram. So histogram is basically used for frequency measurement of any one variable. You can see it looks a bit similar as the bar graph only, but yes, it is not the bar graph. So basically histograms are used for the frequency measurement of any variable. I will share some links related to the histogram, like this website is there. So here good content related to histogram is present. I will share some links in the description and you can just go through them. So to understand the histogram in a better sense. Now coming back to my matplotlib, and I'm going to create a our histogram. And you can see that we have already imported these two packages, the modules here, the NumPy module and the matplotlib, we have already imported. So I'm not going to import these here. I'm just going to start with the variables which we need. So here I'm taking a list of ages. So different age I am providing here. So different age, random ages I am taking here. And I am just making sure that I am taking the age between 0 to 100. Like, it's not compulsory, you can take anything. But right now I am taking the age between 0 to 100, and that is the range. And we have to give this range also, we have to define the range also. So we should know that which consideration we are taking. I will tell you that what is the meaning of bin. So basically it will appear on the y axis, it is just a variable right now. And plt.hist is used for the histogram graph. Ages is our variable which will act on the x-axis, then bins on the y-axis. Range I am providing here, and then the color. So color, I am taking green, by default it will come in blue. And hist type equals to bar. After that, here we need our width to define the width. I am taking 0.7. we can take anything, we will just change it and check it for different values. After that, I'm taking plt.x label. So on the x axis, the label which will appear would be ages. So and plt.y label I will take for the y axis. So I'm writing here bins. Okay, after that, I'm taking plt.title, that would be the title of the graph. So that is histogram plot. We are talking about a graph, so you can call it a plot or a graph, both are correct. plt.show to show the graph, and I'm just going to run it with the help of control enter. Okay, there's some error on the line number 4. So on the line number 4, that is this particular line, plt.hist, I have provided the ages, the bins, the range, the color, and the hist type bar, R width 0.7. Okay, so you can see that it is here now. It was not actually having any error, because I just have to restart the kernel. So I've just restarted the kernel and I have run all the codes here. So it is coming now. There was no error. Basically it was just unable to identify this plt, which we have already taken on the first first cell we have taken. Anyways, you can see that no value is coming here on the 100th one, because I have not taken any value in this range. So let's increase some value here also. So I'm taking 98. I wanted to take 98. And I'm also taking 97. Okay. So we'll just run it. And now, okay, it's... okay, I have just taken 98 here. Fine. So you can see some values are here now. On that particular 100 and between 100 and 80 also. So now you can just change the width also. Just I'm just changing the width from 0.7 to 0.4, so it will be a bit thinner as compared to the previous one. You can see the width has been changed. I'm just changing it to 6 now. So you can see the width is getting changed. So our width we have to take, and the color, if I've taken like green, so it was coming green. Like I'm just going to take orange. So we can just change the color of the graph also. So this is our complete graph, histogram graph. I hope you have understood this particular code and you are not having any problem. If you are having some problem, you can just ask your query in the comment section. Don't forget to subscribe FameWorld Educational Hub and press the notification for the latest uploads, because a lot of videos are going to come in this particular series. Stay tuned. See you in the next lecture.